This is a very long title, but in fact, this is about the science in Wikipedia, and also about automatic knowledge. I am Carlos G. Figuerola, and Miguel Ángel are my colleagues, and we are member researchers at the Institute of Studies on Science and Technology from the University of Salamanca. So, all of us, we know Wikipedia has a big amount of knowledge inside. Every day, millions of users use Wikipedia for a quantity of purposes, but also for teaching and education. Wikipedia is often a controversial thing about the quality of their content. As editors and authors of articles of Wikipedia are anonymous, this fact brings that articles are maybe non-trusted. But from several years ago, there are a lot of scientific papers about the quality, the reliability of Wikipedia contents. There has been tests, comparisons, evaluations, measurements, and so on. Most of these papers, of these studies, conclude that the quality of Wikipedia content is very high in general. One of the strengths of Wikipedia is their social nature, so errors, mistakes, and so on, even sabotage, are fixed immediately by users. Anyway, this paper, this our work, is not about the quality of Wikipedia, but about the science in Wikipedia and, in particular, the vision, the image of science in Wikipedia. Remember, this is a work in progress, and these are preliminary results, only a first look on these topics. If we want to analyze science in Wikipedia, we need to locate the articles, the scientific articles, inside Wikipedia. And we have a hard problem, because Wikipedia, in Spanish version, has about more than 1 million of articles, and more than 30 million hyperlinks between these articles. So this is too big to work by hand with that. Articles in Wikipedia are classified in categories. But categories in Wikipedia, you know, these are like free keywords. One author or one editor of one article can classify this article in any category, even in several categories, and also any editor can create new categories on the fly. So we have in this version of Wikipedia around 60,000 of categories, and this is still too big to drill by hand. We users, automatic techniques. So we can represent Wikipedia as a network. Every article in Wikipedia, we can represent it as a node, and the hyperlinks between articles, we can represent them as edges in such a network. So, for example, we have the Spanish article for Pato, duck, has several links to another articles inside Wikipedia. For example, has a hyperlink to article of birds, aves. So, Pato is a node, aves is another node, and this hyperlink is a direct edge in this network. So we have had Wikipedia as a network, and we can apply techniques from networks analysis. A network community, for example, is a bunch of nodes that they link strongly between them, and they link weakly with the other nodes outside of this bunch. This is a community, and for example, this is only a small piece of the Wikipedia, but we can see the points are the articles, and the lines are the edges, the links, and we can see we have points who are represented closer, because they are strongly linked between them. We can apply several algorithms to communities discovery in a network. After several tries, we use one of them, called InfoMap, which is very good with big networks, and also is very fast. So after automatic discovering of communities, we got more than 1,000 of communities. This is a high number of communities, but if we represent these communities sorted by their size, by the number of articles in each of communities, we can see that only a few of them have the majority, the most part of the articles in Wikipedia. So analyzing by hand only 200 or 250 first communities, we cover the 98% of articles of Wikipedia. If we analyze these communities, and if we classify them in broad topics, we can see that the Spanish Wikipedia has the big part of articles about countries, places, geographical articles. After that, the second part are articles about science and or technology topics. And after, we have humanities, sports, articles about TV, music, movies, games, and so on. And after, more little amount of articles about social science, including education science, and finally others, another several topics. This is the network of articles about science art or technology. We have a lot of articles about the 17% of the all or Africans in Wikipedia. But a part of these articles are only articles of elements belonging to a taxonomic tree, for example, plants, asteroids, animal species, and so on. And a big part of these kind of articles have only their place in the taxonomic tree, without any kind of information, of additional information. If we put apart this kind of taxonomic articles, we got the articles with real content about science and technology. So, if we apply these automatic methods to communities' discovery to this set of articles about science and technology, we got 9 communities only inside science, and we can see these communities, their size in articles, and also the homophily index. The homophily index range from -1 to 1 positive, and below 0 is we have homophily. This means these articles links with similar articles and no link with not similar articles. This is a feature of this kind of communities, because the general index of homophily for all the Wikipedia is 0.89. So in the rest of Wikipedia, we don't have homophily at all. If we represent scientific knowledge in Wikipedia, we have these communities. We tend to represent them closer upon their links, and we can see these communities don't fit the classical classification division of science. We have, for example, a lot of articles about military technology, and we have, for example, in the other side, a little amount of quantities of articles of maths, which links, in most cases, with nothing, only with other articles of maths. Maths is an isolated topic inside Wikipedia. More or less is the same or more similar with zoology, botanical articles. Also for paleontology and earth science, and so on. Health science has a lot of articles, and part of them, link with another topics, but not all of these articles. I'm going to finish with conclusions. Conclusions for us, important conclusions are 2. First, these kind of techniques are useful to deal with big data. And this kind of techniques, maybe in the future, can allow us to analyze these communities, what happened inside these communities, and what is their internal structure. It's all. Thank you very much.